Australia will get NSMs for the Navy's Hobart-class air warfare destroyers. It's a very new, stealthy, anti-ship cruise missile that has a range of more than 370 kilometres. It's very smart, using artificial intelligence to identify and select its target. This would be a huge change for the Army. The Defence Strategic Review was an independent review of Australia's defence posture, based around the idea that we may no longer have a decade of strategic warning time before a major conflict in our region. Mainly that's thinking about a contingency involving Taiwan, which Xi Jinping says must be reunited with the mainland. But there are a whole range of scenarios in the classified version of the report, which was accepted by the government and is now a key guiding plan for defence investment. The DSR reprioritised a whole lot of projects, $7.8 billion worth over the forward estimates, to give the ADF more long-range firepower and get it sooner. It's about modernising the ADF, deterring would-be attackers and denying them access to vast areas to prevent attacks on our own territory and personnel. There'll be some losers from this process, particularly the Army, which lost hundreds of armoured vehicles, which had been on the order books for years. But the Army will also get new land-based missile launchers, like the HIMARS system, which has been used so effectively in Ukraine. And long-range anti-ship missiles that could be placed on islands to our north to pick off enemy ships heading towards us. So, HIMARS. The M142 High Mobility Artillery Rocket System. It's a US-made surface-to-surface rocket launcher developed in the late 1990s, mounted on the back of a tactical truck. The system can launch different types of missiles, such as the MGM-140 Army Tactical Missile, which has a range of 300 kilometres. Australia's getting the next generation precision strike missile, which will have a range of about 500 kilometres, but that'll be extended even further in time. The system is highly accurate, and as we've seen in Ukraine, it's very hard to counter because it can shoot and scoot. That's the high mobility part and what makes the weapon so effective. HIMARS may in the future be able to launch anti-ship missiles such as the Lockheed Martin AGM-158C long-range anti-ship missile, or LRASM, but that's some way off. The Air Force is getting LRASMs for its fleet of Super Hornets, and the missile in the future will be able to be carried by the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter. It's a very new, stealthy, anti-ship cruise missile that has a range of more than 370 kilometres. It's very smart, using artificial intelligence to identify and select its target. It can be used in multiple missile swarms, is resistant to electronic jamming, and has a low radar signature to avoid detection. With such a long range, the missile can be fired hundreds of kilometres away from its intended target, protecting the aircraft that launched it and its crew. Also on defence's shopping list is the Naval Strike Missile, or NSM. Manufactured by Norway's Kongsberg Defence, it's used by a range of countries including the US, the UK and Germany. The NSM is a modern missile. It has a range of at least 250 kilometres and it has a stealthy design to avoid detection. It can fly over and around landmasses, skim the sea and make random manoeuvres as it closes in on its target to avoid countermeasures. This would be a huge change for the Army. NSM launches could be hidden on islands to deny an enemy access to vast swathes of sea. The Boeing MQ-28 Ghost Bat drone is another capability that will be prioritised in cooperation with the United States. The drone is still in development, but it's showing lots of promise. It'll be a sophisticated and relatively high-cost drone that can operate as a so-called loyal wingman to manned fighter jets. The idea is that one or more of the drones, perhaps up to six, will fly forward of piloted fighters. The Ghost Bat, is being developed in Australia, and Defence is hopeful the aircraft will give the ADF a sophisticated unmanned capability that can do a whole lot of things. It'll have interchangeable multi-mission nose cones for reconnaissance, electronic warfare and strike missions. It'll also have very long endurance, staying aloft for some 16 hours, and will have a range of about 3,700 kilometres, which is about 1,500 more than the F-35 it's designed to support. The key now for the government and defence is to move quickly, plough through roadblocks and overcome its plodding procurement culture. There's no time to waste.